हेलो क्लास सिक्स, टुडे आवर टॉपिक फॉर डिस्कशन इज प्रोपोर्शन। नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड नो व्हाट इज ए प्रोपोर्शन। स्टेटमेंट दैट सेज दैट टू रेशियोज आर इक्वल इज कॉल्ड अ प्रोपोर्शन। लाइक फॉर एग्जांपल, वी हैव टू रेशियोज हियर, 2:3 एंड 4:6। ओके, टू रेशियोज, लेट अस सी वेदर दीज टू रेशियोज आर इक्वल और नॉट। नाउ हाउ डू वी डू दैट? Convert it into fraction. So 2:3 can be written as 2/3. Same way, 4:6 can be written as 4/6. Now 4/6 can be cancelled using 2's table. So 2 2's are 4 and 2 3's are 6. So ultimately we get here 2/3. So this ratio also gives us 2/3. This ratio also gives us 2/3. That means both these ratios are equal to each other. So 2:3 and 4:6 are equal. So we can say that these two ratios are in proportion to each other. Okay, 2:3 and 4:6 are equal. Why do we say they're equal? You can see here, 2:3 the value is 2/3, 4:6 value also is 2/3 on solving. So we say that 2:3 and 4:6 are in proportion. So I know by now you must be clear what is proportion. So in symbolically, that means by short form, we can write 2:3 and then these four dots. These four dots means is proportion to. So 2:3 is proportion to 4:6. Okay, so when do we say that two ratios are in proportion? We say that two ratios are in proportion when both the ratios on solving are found to have equal value. Okay, I hope I know it's clear what a proportion is. Okay, in proportion, there is an important relation that is to be learned. And that relation is product of means is equals to product of extremes. So first we need to know what are means and what are extremes. So in our current example only, that is the example of 2:3 in proportion with 4:6, these two numbers which are on the extreme right side and extreme left side, they are called extremes because they are in the corners. Corners means extremes, they are located in the extreme positions, extreme left and extreme right. And these two numbers which are in the middle, they are called means. So if you apply this particular relation in this proportion, and let us verify whether this particular relation is true or not. So in this particular proportion, product of means, product means multiplication, okay? So let us multiply those numbers which are means, that is 3 and 4. So 3 into 4 is 12. Product of extremes, these are the extreme numbers. So product means multiplication of the extremes. So 2 into 6 are the extreme numbers. Let us multiply 2 into 6, we get 12. See, product of means also comes 12, product of extreme is also 12. So therefore we can say that the relation is true. Okay, this particular relation I'm talking about, product of means equals to product of extreme. So remember, in a proportion, or suppose four numbers are given to us and they have asked whether they are in proportion or not, how to find out? If this relation holds good, then those four numbers will be regarded to be in proportion. Like in this case, okay, the means and here are the extremes. When you multiply the means, the number that you get should be equals to what you get by multiplying the extremes. Let us see one example that is given in your book. On page number 175 in your book, you have an example which says, determine if the following numbers are in proportion. These are the numbers. We have to find out whether 2, 3, 4 and 5 with their specific locations as it is, are they in proportion or not. So in the corners, which are the corner numbers? 2 and 5. So these are the numbers which are extremes, 2 and 5. So let us find product of extremes. Product means multiplication of extremes. So multiply the numbers which are in extremes. So 2 into 5 gives 10. Next is which are the means. The numbers which are in the middle, they are called means. So here 3 and 4 are the means, and product of means is 3 into 4, which is 12. So product of means is 12. So as you can see, product of extreme is 10 and product of means is 12. They are not equal. So since product of means is not equal to product of extremes, so therefore 2, 3, 4 and 5 are not in proportion. So these numbers cannot be made into proportion. Now in that same example, you have part 2 also, and here are the numbers in part 2, 4, 6, 8 and 12. With their particular locations, they have asked whether we can make proportion with the help of 4, 6, 8 and 12. So which are the numbers in the extremes? 4 and 12 are in the extremes. So find the product of extremes. So 4 and 12 are the extremes. Find their product. Product means multiplication. So 4 into 12 is 48. Which are the numbers which are in the mean? The middle numbers, 6 and 8, are in the means. So product of means is 6 into 8 is 48. Now you can see product of extreme is also 48. Product of means is also 48. So since you have both product of means equals to product of extremes, or product of extreme equals to product of means, so we can say that 4, 6, 8 and 12 are in proportion. So since they are in proportion, 4, 6, 8 and 12, so we can write 4 is to 6 is equals to 8 is to 12. You know, in proportion the two ratios are equal. So the ratio made by 4 and 6 and the ratio made by 8 and 12 are equal to each other. That's what is the meaning of proportion. Okay. Now let us go to exercise 8C. In exercise 8C also we have a similar question. In question number 1, 4 numbers have been given. They have asked whether these 4 numbers are in proportion or not. So out of the 4 numbers, you can see 8 and 20 are extremes. So I have found product of extremes. 8 into 20 is 160. 10 and 16 are means. So product of means is 10 into 16. That is also 160. So since product of extreme is equals to product of means, therefore 8, 10, 16 and 20 are in proportion. And we can write that 8 is to 10 is equals to 16 is to 20. Okay, this is the meaning of the 4 numbers being in proportion. The next number that I have done is part 4. After 1, I have done part 4. So I expect that you do part 2 and part 3 by yourself. Okay, coming to part 4. Here also we have been given 4 numbers. And they have asked, determine if the following are in proportion. So as usual, we find the extreme numbers and multiply them to find product of extremes. So extremes are 5 into 56. That comes to 80. Similarly, the middle numbers are means. So product of means is 7 into 40. That is also 280. So both cases we get 280. So since product of extremes equals to product of means, so these 4 numbers 5, 7, 40 and 56 are in proportion, and we can write it this way. 5 is to 7, the ratio with 5 is to 7, 5 and 7, that is 5 is to 7, is equals to the ratio with 40 and 56, that is 40 is to 56. These two ratios are equal, and since these two ratios are equal, so they are in proportion. These numbers are in proportion. The next question, question number 2, is also similar to question number 1. It also says, determine if the following ratios form proportion. Now you have here 80 centimeter to 4 meter. So the ratio that you can form with 80 centimeter is to 4 meter is this. 80 centimeter to, remember, in a ratio you have to have both the units equal. So 4 meter is converted into 400 centimeter. Remember, 1 meter is 100 centimeter. So 4 meter will be 400 centimeter. Okay. And the next ratio is rupees 7 to rupees 35. Okay. So the ratio that we can form with 80 centimeter with 400 centimeter is 80 is to 400. And the ratio that you can make with rupees 7 and rupees 35 is 7 is to 35. Okay. So we have two ratios, 80 is to 400, 7 is to 35. they are asking if these ratios form a proportion. When two ratios form a proportion? When the two ratios are equal. So let us first find out these two ratios, whether they are equal or not. Convert the ratio into fraction form. So 80 will be in the numerator, 400 will be in the denominator. For this ratio also, 7 will be in the numerator, 35 will be in the denominator. Now use cancelling method. So as you can see, I have cancelled. First I have cancelled each 110, numerator and denominator. Then you have 8 and 40 remaining. So 8 1s are 8, 8 5s are 40. So after cancelling, we get 1 by 5. After cancelling this ratio or this fraction, we get 1 by 5. So 80 is to 400, the value is 1 by 5. Similarly, let us find for this particular ratio, what's the value? So 7 is in the numerator, 35 is in the denominator. With 7's table, 7 1 is 7, 7 5 is 35. So this value is also 1 by 5. So we see that both the ratios have the same value, 1 by 5. So that is the meaning of proportion, isn't it? When both ratios values are equal, is equal, then only we say that the both ratios are in proportion. So in this case also, since both ratios value is 1 by 5, so they are in proportion. So these two are in proportion. The next question is part 2. Again here you have two sets of numbers, 24 millimeter to 30 centimeter. And another set of number, 20 gram to 720 gram. So the ratio that will be made with these two set of numbers, I mean this set of numbers, is 24 millimeter to, the centimeter is converted into millimeter. Remember, 1 centimeter is 10 millimeter, so 30 centimeters will be 30 into 10, 300 millimeter. So unless you make the units equal, you cannot make the ratio with these two numbers. So now the units are made equal. So the ratio is 24 is to 300. No units will be written in the ratio. Similarly here also. Now here we have both the numbers with the same unit, so no need to convert. So the ratio can be formed, 20 is to 270. So we have two ratios once again, 24 is to 300 and 20 is to 270. Convert them into fractional form, do the cancelling part and check. Now as you can see, I have done the cancelling part over here. And I get 2 by 25 for this particular ratio, 24 is to 300. And for this particular ratio, 20 is to 270, I get 2 by 27. This is 2 by 25 and this is 2 by 27. Obviously, they are not equal. Since both ratios are not same, so they are not in proportion. So this and this are not in proportion. Third number. 800 milliliter is to 300 milliliter and then rupees 560 is to rupees 210. So while writing ratio, we will ignore the units. Now units are same in both cases, both the numbers, antecedent and consequent, the units are same. So you can make the ratio directly, no conversion needed. 800 is to 300. In this case also both units are same, rupees. So you can make the ratio 560 is to 210. Now convert them into fraction and do the cancelling part and see what you get the result. So 800 is to 300 you can convert by writing as numerator and denominator, and doing cancelling you get 8 by 3. Similarly, 560 is to 210 also can be written in numerator and denominator form, and after doing cancellation here also we get 8 by 3. Both ratios have same value. So since both ratios are same, they are in proportion. So these two ratios are in proportion. Okay, the next one. 450 meter is to 3 kilometer. This is one ratio. 75 centimeter is to 7 meter. This is another ratio, but the units are not matching in both cases. So kilometer will be converted to meter. 3 kilometer means 3000 meter. In this case, meter will be converted to centimeter. So 7 meter equals to 700 centimeter. So now you can match the units in this one also and in this one also and make the ratio. So with the ratio, no units will be there. This ratio is converted into fractional form. This ratio also is converted into fractional form. And after doing the cancelling part, For this one we get 3 by 20 and for this one we get 3 by 28. So they are not matching. Since both ratios are not same, so they are not in proportion.